dragon had been called forth from his celestial roost to bring judgment down upon all who dared to defy his ruthless master. And it was none other than Dragon who spirited away the souls of children each night on the tyrant's behalf. That's right. Dragon was part of the reason Kutaro got dragged into this mess in the first place. But now, the stakes were much higher. The souls of every last boy and girl on Earth. Having parted the heavens and opened a portal to Earth, Dragon set to work harvesting the souls of children from the coils of their nightmares.
Dragon! Bring me those souls right now!
If the Moon Bear King devours all those, we'll have a disaster on our hands! Not only will I not rule the moon, he'll rule the whole dark universe! Come on, Kutaro! Up to it! Stop that monster!
Whoosh! Kutaro watched Dragon soar off with a host of children's souls in his wake. With Picarina at his side, Kutaro hopped astride the newly emancipated Mr. Pink and...
Hold on!
Dark clouds hung heavy over the Black Castle as General Dragon hurtled home as fast as he could. Mr. Pink skimmed along the dragon's back as Kutaro held on tight.
I suppose now would be a good time to lay down the facts. Well, there's nothing to lay them on, but metaphorically speaking, you see, I'm primarily an academic. I look after a big clock for a living.
Man, if I knew spicy food would shut him up, I would have ordered some buffalo wings hours ago.
Dashingly, Mr. Pink leapt over Dragon's blade-like fin. Bolts of lightning struck and missed. Storm clouds shot in vain. Nothing could stop them as they raced up the riding dragon's back to the heavens.
Use the balloon to jump!
Mr. Pink flapped so hard, his wings looked ready to snap. Whence came this passion? Was it rage toward the Moon Bear King for using him as a clock hand? Was it a sense of justice, a need to undo his mistakes?
It's damnable bad luck is what it is. What do you mean, my mistakes? I'm not the one who broke the clock. Besides, the warranty ran out ages ago.
That's right! Damn the lightning death that was raining down on him. Mr. Pink was determined to set things right.
Yeah, that's not what I said. Don't fabricate stories.
General Dragon tore across the sky with his sinister prize in tow. Soon, he would deliver
Harry,
all these children to his master.
You want the Moon Bear King to gobble up the soul of every last one on Earth?
You say hurry like I'm not already hurrying, which I am, by the way, but I am a flamingo, in case you haven't noticed.
Flamingo power!
Mr. Pink's body coursed with the hot, holy justice of capsaicin. The bird's heart and muscles swelled with new purpose after every massive, peppery kick. A cyclone tossed Kutaro into the path of lightning and rain, but these and more he's cut in twain. Either the clock tower disaster or General Dragon's own power had triggered a great cataclysm. Volcanoes exploded in a salvo of magma destruction as fireballs rained down from above.
Incoming!
Kutaro picked up speed, bounded along the balloons, and rocketed right through the eruption.
Don't I get any credit?
Our hero sliced through rain and dodged bolts of lightning as he tamed the vicious storm.
We need
egg that's in the clouds if you expect me to fly when I can't even see where I'm going, which would be just like you, actually.
The dragon's trunk was coiled around the clouds like a snake's. Meanwhile, the volcanoes had taken things up a notch. Fiery boulders smashed apart the clouds. It seemed as though General Dragon's body stretched on forever.
How are we going to catch him with all this junk in the way?
The eruption had grown so intense, it seemed the whole sky might soon be snuffed out.
We gotta improvise. Katara, just start hacking off pieces of dragon. That's it. Plus it clean off.
Only once Kutaro had done a little surgery did the proud and powerful dragon finally.
Did you seriously just cut off my tail? Tell me you didn't just cut off my tail, because that is just red! Don't even make me spell out the dookie you're in right now! I got more trunk where that came from!
Got him!
To smash you instead. I got more trunk where that came from.
That's it! Almost there!
Our hero dodged searing balls of fire and danced between dragons' razor-sharp scales as they battled atop the clouds.
Thank you.
sliced right through Dragon's thunderclouds as he raced across the ether.
This is my sky! My clouds! You don't get to be a wise guy with me!
Oh, great! Now we've upgraded to full-on dragon breath. Ugh.
Oh, you're begging for some heart!
And lunged over lightning bolts.
Look out for the gap in the clouds!
To settle with Dragon.
You've got a dragon to catch! Whoa! A little
too
close!
Oh, you really want to take a fall? I'll knock that head clean off your shoulders!
You're trapped, Katara. The only way out is up.
Where you going? Just getting started. Let's see if those scissors you used against my pals can smoke a dragon. Die! Ah! Oh, so you want some juice? That what you want? Have some of this! What? Hold still, pipsqueak. You fight good. But I ain't giving up my piece of the boss's moonstone. Not to nobody! You can kiss the earth! That's a little adventure! Goodbye!
Hold it right there! I've had enough of your bullying and that stupid accent! Don't you make me go full Picarina on you! Katara, you may be from Earth, but you're our hero! I know you can win! You can beat us!
Kid, let's settle this like men! The Dragon Man, bring it on! You got me.
Yes! We did it! Katara, you are one stellar superhero.
After an epic battle, the wicked dragon had been slain, and the souls of the children were free once again.
Katara! Another piece of the puzzle! Just One more shard! And Monkey's business is no match for ours. Hey! Wait just a solar second! We beat Dragon! What gives?
You're too late! All you did was ensure the gateway between the Earth and Moon stays open! Now, I need only wait.
Soon, the Moonbear King would possess a more terrible power than ever.
But Kataro risked everything to stop the dragon. It can't have been for nothing. No, it's too soon to give up. We've still got the Moon Goddess. If we put the Moonstone back together, we can bring her back too. And with her on our side, that half-baked grizzly is toast. We've got to stay positive. Let's go find Monkey and make him cough up that last piece.
That's right. You'll get your goddess. Now would you just hurry up?
Goddess or no goddess, the tyrant's too strong now. If we get the Moonstone back, Mew should send Kotaro home where he belongs.
Don't be crazy. Why would I ever do that? Kotaro is our last hope, especially mine.
You go, man! You stuck that warty nose of yours in my business for the last time!
Yowzers, this is terrible.
With the dragon down and one Moonstone shard to go, Kotaro was certainly on a roll. But with the witch in the tyrant's clutches and the power of countless souls at stake, it seemed the rolling would be uphill from here on out. With the help of Calibrus, Kotaro defeated the menace and saved the souls of a lucky few. Well done, Kotaro! The souls he freed were homeward bound. Kotaro had decommissioned Dragon, but now the Moonbear King possessed a dreadful power. With the witch in captivity, what was a hero to do? The stage is set for the final act in Kotaro's saga.